Yeah, what is happening, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back once again to another First Descendant video. And today we're going to be talking about the best way, in my opinion, to play Valby. This is kind of a beginner's guide for Valby. I should imagine the majority of the people who are watching this video are going to be beginners. They're going to be new to this character. They might not know, you know, how to use this character, what synergizes well with her. However, if you've been using this character for a long time, you kind of understand her core mechanics and how she plays. This isn't the video for you, so you may as well just stop watching now. But if you're new to Valby, I think that this video is going to be very informative for you and it's going to improve your gameplay. If you are new here, guys, if you want to see more First Descendant content, please subscribe to the channel. It's totally free, guys. It doesn't cost you a penny. And if you want to see more guides, First Descendant videos from me, please smash that like button because it really helps put my content out there to more people on YouTube. So let's talk about Valby and basically how she works. So Valby, she's described, well, it says there on front of your screen, Valby, the shape of water. So obviously all her abilities evolve around water. She doesn't deal any elemental damage, which we'll talk about that later. So let's just go over her skills at this moment. So a passive skill is called water intake. Now, again, it's a non-attribute skill, which we'll talk about that later. Don't want to confuse people too soon. So when using skills while on water, your magic power cost decreases. So that is the power it takes to actually, you know, do your abilities. Puddles created by skills are also considered to be water. So the skills, this is your main one called Water Bubble. It fires a bouncing water bubble where the bubble impacts. It creates a small puddle at the point of collision. Enemies who touch the small puddle take continuous damage and are inflicted with laundry. The bubble explodes upon hitting an enemy or after bouncing a maximum number of times, which is 4. It's obviously got all the stats there. We don't really need to go into too much of that, but ultimately, you know, your Q on keyboard and mouse. Don't really know what keybind it is on consoles, but you're going to be using this quite a lot. It's one of the core skills for what you're going to use Valby for. So this one, Flop Flop, as it's called, or Plop Plop is probably the better way of pronouncing it. I can't even read, guys. Yet I'm trying to do a video on YouTube telling people how to play this character. So this is probably her best ability, in my opinion, apart from the ultimate. But again, you know, of the three core skills, this is definitely the one you're going to be using. So basically, she dives down where she's stood and then dives back up in a location fairly close to it. And it creates puddles both when she dives down and then when she comes back up. Massive AoE damage. And again, it performs laundry. This is a dimension of attack as well, so you can have modifiers on your reactors, modules, all that kind of stuff. So you can make this, you know, do even more damage. Again, all the stats on the right hand side of the screen, we don't really need to know that. But ultimately, guys, this is going to be the ability you want to use when you first start off a fight. So as soon as the enemies spawn in from the dropships, you can normally tell where they're going to spawn in. You basically want to press C on your keyboard or whatever it is on console, and spawn right up into them, does damage straight away. And the big thing about this ability is that it actually is a CC. So it'll stun most enemies. It'll knock them to the floor. You can shoot them for a bit. They can't attack you. Absolutely amazing. One of the best abilities on the game I've come across so far. Your V, which not a lot of people know this, which this skill, you activate liquefied state. Now, while you're liquefied, you don't collide with any enemies and it creates a waterway on the ground. Enemies standing in the waterway take continuous damage and are inflicted with laundry. In a liquefied state, which you cannot jump or use skills. So, again, apart from the obvious, what I've just read there, there's a few things it doesn't tell you about this ability. Number one, if you fall from a gate height and you're liquefied, you just continue moving. You don't kind of stutter as you're as you drop and you can't move momentarily. This as well makes you move just as fast as what Bunny does when she's you know, sprinting and using her overcharged ability. So again, this gives you increased movement speed. However, what I use this more for, well, I use this just because, right, it actually reduces the damage you take. So where does it actually say this? It says it's somewhere.
What do you get when you...
There we go. Damage reduction while liquefied is 50%. So normally if I go low health and I've not got much health left, I activate liquefied state, which again is V on keyboard and mouse. Again, couldn't tell you what it is on console. But as soon as you've got low damage, so your shields have gone, you've not got much health, press V, you go in liquefied state. You're harder to hit because you're moving quicker, so you're able to, you know, kind of get out of the way of incoming fire. But you take 50% less damage, and what you want to be doing in that part of the game is looking for the little red health boxes what drop on the floor. I'm sure you're all well aware of what they are. You'll get them, and then that's it. That's kind of what I use that ability for. And then, as we've said, the passive also helps you kind of control your magic power costs. And I don't really have that much issues running out of MP. Magic power with Valby, so again that's probably just because of this passive what she's got called water intake. So that leads us to the laundry bomb. This is your ultimate. So basically, if any of the enemies are inflicted with laundry, so basically you've hit them with any of your other abilities, you can actually launch this bomb. I think you get three shots. Don't know if you can modify that. I don't think you can. So you get three shots, you fire it anywhere near the enemies, and it pulls them in. So the game actually calls that towel wet. That's kind of how my brain works, guys. So basically that creates toad on enemies. So when you fire the bubble, if it doesn't exactly hit an enemy, it kind of pulls them in quite far as well. So any enemy within the, what's it say? Radius of 8 meters, it pulls them in, guys. So again, a very, very good ability. Now, the great thing with this as well is that if you look here on the bottom right of the screen, anything what's got laundry actually gives a 20% decrease to enemies' electric resistance and non-attribute resistant damage. So again, all our attributes are non-attributes, so we're going to get 20% more damage with our skills. But the big thing is here, and this is, well, this is really, really relevant. Pretty much everybody's playing Bunny at the moment. Bunny deals electric damage. So while you're putting all these puddles down and creating laundry status on enemies, Bunny's going to be essentially doing a lot more damage because you've decreased their electric damage modifier by 20%. So arguments say you're going to do 20% more damage. It's not as straightforward as that in the math, but for the purpose of this video. So that's kind of a quick overview of how Bunny works. And I just want to kind of talk about this as well, because you want a weapon what ideally does electric damage. I know this is subjective depending on what content you're doing, but as a general rule of thumb, the Thunder Gun works brilliantly. And the only reason I say Thunder Gun works brilliantly is because basically the overcharge ability here, which we'll just read it. When defeating an enemy, the defeated enemy has a set chance to discharge electric shockwave, which deals additional damage to enemies. So again, I should imagine people use the Thunder Gun enough. It kind of procs a lot where you just burst of electric damage. And again, they've got laundry. It's going to do more damage. So the Thunder Gun works brilliantly with Valby. Water electricity obviously doesn't mix. We know that in the real world. So the last thing I want to talk about in this video, and again, this is pretty much subjective, but I'm coming towards the end of the game on normal difficulty now. By no means am I end game. However, there's a lot of people who struggle because they die too much in this game. And we're at the point now where I don't really die that much, but I only end up dying because I'm in a public event and there's four of us and the enemies are scaled appropriately. I very rarely die. And that's because a lot of people just get obsessed with DPS numbers and skill damage and just basically they're all glass cannons. So I'm going to go over kind of what I use myself. So we was talking about one of the abilities. The only reason I got Valby originally was because I dropped this 1%, which is called Water Play. So instead of my Q just doing little bubbles, what bounce, which is harder to hit, this just does like a rectangular shape bang in front you can't miss. That is a must have, but you've only got a 1% drop rate, so likelihood is you're not going to get that. So what I have on, and I'll kind of talk about it while we go through them. So maximize skill, one of the best ones to have on. Skill power 66%, skill cooldown 40%, It's a no-brainer, really. Polygenic antibody. Again, I've maxed this up to the top. 640.8% all attribute resistance. Again, you've got to make your characters tanky. If you don't, you're just going to die all the time. And again, Valby and the majority of the people who I play with, like there's loads of bunnies knocking around. Nobody's got healing abilities to actually help you. So you've just got to either wait for your shields to regen, which take quite a while. Or you've got to just hope that the luck is with you and you can find some reb health orbs on the floor. So I've got Agony, 30, not really because of the max MP, but defense, 38.5% extra defense, which is huge. I've got increased shield again, survivability, plus 15%. Shock punch, I've put as many points in that as possible because every point you put into it actually increases your module capacity. I've not really done a video about how all the inner workings of this work. Like you can see, I've got green icons there. That's not really for this video, but yeah, it's to do with your module additional settings, which again, there's going to be videos on the internet talking about that. Weighing the scales, which I've just took off. Max shield again, 42.3%. Skill cost, wow, minus 3.7, doesn't really matter. Again, I've not even leveled that up to max, but again, you need a lot of shield, a lot of health towards endgame. Regeneration boost, I kind of didn't understand how this worked. I actually had to test it myself. But ultimately, guys, you know, you don't have any health recovery in this game, I believe. You definitely don't with any character I've used. I don't know if any of the other characters, sorry, descendants later on, have, you know, HP what just regenerates on its own. I don't think they do. I kind of had a quick look on the internet beforehand. But basically what this does, guys, is you get 15.8% more health when you pick up a red orb on the game. That's what it does. Okay, kind of a bit disappointed. It's not as good as what I thought it was going to be. But again, you're getting near enough your full health by picking one orb up instead of like a quarter. So it kind of does make a good difference. Increased HP, which again just increases your total health. And then skill expansion, skill effect range, 38.7%. These are not what I'm going to use for the entire game. This is just what I'm using at the moment. But ultimately, you just want to make sure you don't die a lot, because you will die a lot. A lot of people who play this game at the beginning think it's really easy. When you get later on, you do start dying, guys. You know, especially some of the Colossus, you know, they kind of one-shot you, or they can just kill you very, very quickly. So that is ultimately my guide. There's no real point going over the weapon. The only weapon you kind of need to look at is the Thunder Gauge. Again, you could probably get better stat rolls on that. I've got Toxic ATK. I could actually go here and try to get Electric ATK if I was trying to, you know, max everything out. But ultimately, there's no point, because as you level up your weapon, you'll actually get higher rolls on weapon readjustment. So that's pretty much it, guys. There's no real point dragging this video on any longer. Valby is a very, very good character. Sorry, Descendant. I keep saying character. I'm used to character. Well, they are characters, but again, Valby's a very, very good Descendant. When I first picked her up, I thought she was garbage. Not gonna lie, but once I got actually used to her abilities, especially the plop plop, as I'm gonna call it now, just to correct myself, that is probably one of the best abilities in the game, just because it gives you CC and it gets you out of some tricky situations, especially when one of your teammates has been knocked. You flop down, flop up where they're knocked. It actually works quite a good distance as well. It knocks all the enemies around them down, gives you time to heal them, resurrect them, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, thank you for watching, everybody. If you've enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, please let me know in the comment section. If you'd add anything to Valby, what I've missed out, please let me know in the comment section so other viewers can see it. And if you've watched right until the end of the video, thank you, and I really appreciate you. And yeah, until next time, thank you. Leave a like. Goodbye for now. Cheerio. Bye-bye.